Good afternoon and welcome to Bobcat Update. I'm Ernesto Diaz.
And I'm Kendall Clark. Thank you for joining us. Texas State has been recognized by the Princeton Review in its 2022 Annual College Guide, the best 387 colleges. The schools included in the guide are not ranked, but only 13% of the four-year colleges in the U.S. are profiled in the book. The colleges are selected based on data collected annually from the administrations about schools' academic offerings. The Princeton Review also considers surveys from college students who rate their experience on campus life. Keep St. Mark is beautiful, a phrase that is well known throughout the city, but making it doesn't happen by chance. This past Saturday, the city organized a cleanup in the downtown area. Bobcat Update's Reed Hartle has a story.
Texas State students and locals came out this past weekend to do some good for the community. For example, volunteers did some weeding on East Hutchinson.
I live here in the city of San Marcos. I go to school here, and I'm really proud to be here. So any chance I can get to keep it clean, keep it safe, you know, make it look the best it can, is I'm all for it.
Several Texas State students assisted in the cleanup effort.
It is so important for us to have volunteer help because we couldn't do it by ourselves. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of work to keep downtown looking presentable to both our visitors and our locals, and we just really appreciate the help, from things to litter cleanup, to weeding, which is what we're doing today, to painting railings. I mean, the more people we have, the more we can accomplish.
If you would like to volunteer in the future, send an email to mainstreet@sanmarcostx.gov. For Bobcat Update, I'm Reed Hartle.
The University Police Department is reminding students that they should keep safety in mind when they are on campus. Already this fall semester, UPD has investigated several crimes. Among them was an armed robbery at Tower Garage, as well as an assault of a female student at Jowers Center. To promote safety, the police department offers self-defense courses, escort assistance, and they conduct investigations when warranted. For more information on personal safety and crime prevention, a place to start is the website police.txsstate.edu. Texas State is a tobacco-free zone, and smoking or vaping on campus may result in consequences. Bobcat Update's Clayton Kelly has a story.
It's been 10 years since Texas State became a tobacco-free campus, and there could be consequences for students and staff who defy the ban. University Police Corporal Tad Palmer says students caught smoking can get reported to the Dean of Students.
They try to work through several steps as far as educating the individual. You know, there might be classes and a probationary period.
More students are moving away from smoking cigarettes and are switching to vape pens. In 2019, Texas State updated its tobacco-free policy to include the use of vape pens.
So usually I see people like outside McCoy on the streets, walking up and down, hit a vape or something like that, you know?
The Student Health Center has resources for those wanting to quit smoking, which includes medications at a discounted rate.
My concern when it comes to having this habit and being in public spaces is not wanting to be in anyone's way.
According to the Texas State University website, visitors caught smoking on campus could face a different charge, including criminal trespassing. For Bobcat Update, I'm Clayton Kelly.
An organization in St. Marcos is trying to decriminalize marijuana use. Their group is called Mano Amiga. It wants to change some laws in Harris County to decriminalize marijuana use. Decriminalization does not make pot use legal, but it makes it a less punishable offense. For more information about the initiative to decriminalize marijuana, visit Mano Amiga's website. The university plans to resume alcohol sales on campus soon. Bobcat Update's Adam Snyder has the story.
Students line up at the UAC Cafe for their favorite seasonal drinks, and soon they'll have more choices. By day, the cafe will serve coffee, and at night, wine.
Every once in a while, you know, someone will be talking about how there's going to be alcohol in the UAC. They were thinking about some kind of, like, wine night stuff that they're planning on doing. They already have glasses and, like, wine spouts in the UAC, but no wine officially yet.
This isn't the first time alcohol has been available on campus. George's, the popular hangout spot on the first floor of the LBJ Student Center, was once known for its selection of beer and wine, but no longer has the ability to sell alcohol.
Yeah, Chartwell's, being the university food service contract provider, the liquor license is in their name, and as a result, because of liquor laws and such, their staff are the only people that can serve alcohol on campus.
While there are legal barriers to George's employees selling alcohol, the UAC Cafe is run by the on-campus catering service Chartwell's, which holds an eligible liquor license. For Bobcat Update, I'm Adam Snyder.
Texas State has a lot of options when looking for a delicious meal. Bobcat Update's Eric Vance takes a look at some of the top choices.
Commons and Harris, where students can load up on food and eat all they care to. Carry-out boxes are an option too.
I like Commons Hall if I want like all you can eat. And then if I don't, I usually go to Jones Hall and eat at like the cafe or like Panda.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner are served at Commons and Harris. Their menus change daily. Jones is the closest dining center to the library and features franchise restaurants that include Mexican and Chinese food. The OBJ Student Center also has some well-known chains like Pizza Hut and Chick-fil-A.
On campus, I mean, I think Chick-fil-A is the go-to, especially, you know, if you're in the biology field, it's a little stressful, so chicken never hurt anybody.
Some students prefer to eat at restaurants that are off campus, but close enough to walk to in between classes.
Torchy's Tacos and the Industry, Chick-fil-A, classic.
Torchy's Tacos is located on Guadalupe Street just beyond the arches of the UAC building. For Bobcat Update, I'm Eric Vance.
Let's take a break.
When we come back, we'll tell you about the Family Fun Week at Texas State and resumption of the Kissing Alley concerts downtown. Stay with us. Family Weekend is coming up at Texas State, which means the university will be showcasing what the campus is all about. Bobcat Update's McKenna Fairbanks tells us some of the activities that will be planned.
Family Weekend is being held on October 8th. Campus tours will be offered during the event.
So we're offering three different tour times that weekend. We're going to do one on Friday and two different times on Saturday. To be in those tours, you just have to sign up for them beforehand. So you'll meet here in the Welcome Center. We're located in the LBJ Student Center on the third floor. You'll see us right as you enter in on that third floor on the right-hand side. There's a big glass wall with the Welcome Center sign on there.
The university plans to show off its Whitliff collections and the Recreation Center. There will also be a picnic at Sewell Park and a home football game against the South Alabama Jaguars.
I'm probably going to take them to see where my classes are, show them around the school. They've never been over here to San Marcos, so it would be pretty cool showing them the part where Sewell is.
Family Weekend events start Friday morning and will last until Sunday night. For Bobcat Update, I'm McKenna Fairbanks.
Live music is making a comeback on the square in San Marcos with bands performing for locals. Bobcat Update's Jalen Beck has more on the story.
It was another perfect summer night as music groups Window Shop and Summer Rental performed at Kissing Alley, located off East Hopkins across from the historic courthouse.
I heard about it from my friends. They just invited me. We had a good time.
Texas State students and locals gathered in masses to witness the event, thankful to finally get out and attend concerts again.
I appreciate the fact that it's outside, you know. It feels right. You know, if that was inside, it'd be different, but, you know, I feel safe with it being at Kissing Alley and stuff like that. You know, it feels good.
San Marcos radio station KZSM host Priscilla Leader and other station volunteers sold shirts, stickers, and other memorabilia throughout the event to help fund both the station and other events.
It feels really good to be out here. It's a very, very pleasant ambiance. Even it's hot out there, but it's cool in the alley and the acoustics are good. So it feels very communal. You know, it's a great place to watch people.
Because KZSM also sponsors the Kissing Alley concert, Leader states that there will be more live events in the near future. For Bobcat Update, I'm Jalen Beck.
That's all we have for you today. Thanks for joining us. I'm Kendall Clark.
And I'm Ernesto Diaz. Bobcat Update returns tomorrow with more news at Texas State.